hope that soup warmed you up. I haven't had a chance to cook for someone for, well, many years. You see, I was young once, like you, when I lost Path. I was 11 years old, and the leaves had changed, had fallen, and covered the dark red of the brick streets below them. I still remember my costume, a ragged witch. My mother spent all night making it, sewing, measuring, stitching, and I hated it. My friends had store-bought costumes, and they all looked better than mine. At least I thought they did. Looking back on them now, they looked pretty awful. It's easy to see things wrong when you're at that age. Any age, really. I was about to head out, and my father wanted to go over the safety rules with me for the 100th time. And this gave my mother the time to find more flaws in her creation. She hemmed and adjusted for what seemed like forever. Trick-or-treating had already begun. I was feeling pretty bad for myself when I finally made my way outside, but I remember the snap of the cold air, the porches lit up with jack-o'-lanterns and decorative cornstalks, plastic skeletons. And I started walking to my friend's house where we were to meet up, and I passed groups of kids dressed as goblins and monsters and every other creature that could be packaged and bought, and I felt absolutely terrible in my witch's costume, made from hand-me-downs and rags. When I finally got to my friend's house, nobody was there. I knocked on the door and asked her mother where they went, and she said they waited for a half an hour before they left. I could feel my cheeks burn and tears welling up in my eyes, and when I asked which direction they went, and I tried my best to hide the disappointment. She closed the door, and Halloween felt ruined. I wanted to scream, but instead my foot found itself embedded into the side of their jack-o'-lantern. I removed my foot and watched the pumpkin roll down the wooden stairs and onto the sidewalk, and it smashed into pieces, and I ran. I searched for my friends. They must have taken a different street. I kept pushing forward, darting through alleys and backyards and calling for them, and each minute I searched was another minute I was losing out on candy. It was growing darker, and a few porch lights were turning off, signaling the end of the holiday. My face was red by the time I came to the end of Tessout Road. Nobody ever really went this way anymore, and I'm not sure how I got there. But I had, and the dark wood at the end of it stretched before me. I would normally have been frightened, but all I could see this time was something else. Somewhere without parents to make me late, without friends to ditch me. The bramble of wood and vine felt welcoming, and if I didn't come home on time or to school the next day, they would be sorry. I took my first tentative steps into the woods. It felt as if the dense brush opened a path for me as I journeyed through. It was then I heard this voice. "Girl, don't go further. Wait there. I will help you home." At first I was startled, but then I resolved to ignore the voice and keep going. I don't know how long I walked, but I finally came to a clearing, and by then I was beyond tired and sleep overtook me. When I awoke, everything felt warm and welcoming, and to my surprise, there was now a table in the middle of the glade, and laid out on top of it was the most amazing breakfast I had ever seen. Pancakes and waffles and wiggly bacon, all my favorite foods. Without hesitation, I ate and became content. And so it went. Whenever I was hungry, a marvelous feast appeared. When I was bored, games and books appeared, each exactly what I wanted. I was always content until I wasn't. Time had lost all meaning to me. With nothing to strive for, nothing to want, there was nothing to measure time except the changes in my hands. I never noticed it day by day. But when I look back years ago, they were once young and smooth. Now the skin is like paper. I'm tired all the time. And I just miss my family and friends, the time we didn't have. I miss my mother's care and work, and I miss my father's lectures. my friends and the Halloweens that would have followed. The glade still provides, but it doesn't sustain. It could not fill my growing loneliness or ease my regrets. I had given up, and I knew this place would be my grave soon. That is when I saw you, a tattered witch, walking toward the glade. So I called out, "Girl, don't go farther. Wait there. I will help you home." You stopped, and I remembered those words. I was sure you would walk on, but you didn't. I don't know why or how, but you did things differently. Somehow I did things differently. And now you need to go home. Come, I will walk you out. See, there it is. That's the road. That's the road home. Now hurry. Hurry home to your family. Our family. Don't worry about me. I'm just fading into the dream of this glade, but because of your choice, I can hope that I will wake up in my bed tomorrow, and I can have those Halloweens again. That's right. Hurry home. Straight home. And beat the last porch light.